Hey everyone, this is a guitar tutorial for Ninevah by Brooke Ligertwood. Before we begin, please consider subscribing to my channel or give this video a like and comment below on what else you want to see in the future. Additionally, if you're interested in any of the gear that you see today, there are links in the description below. Alright, grab your acoustic guitar and you don't need a capo today. Yay! And let's get started. Alright, so let's get started. Really dive in with the chords that you need for this song to make it happen. Before we even talk about chords, you have to understand that this guitar arrangement is something that I kind of made up. There really isn't any acoustic guitar part or definitive acoustic guitar part in the song. The electric guitars do a few little lead lines, but they really just copy the intro that the piano has at the beginning of the song. All right, so here are the chords you need to know. C, F, G, A minor, D minor. So let's break those down. C is just a traditional C chord shape. Index finger, B string, first fret, middle finger, D string, second fret, and your ring finger on the A string, fourth fret. Don't play the low E. For the G chord, put your middle finger on the low E string, third fret, index finger, A string, second fret, and your pinky on the high E, third fret. For A minor, index finger again on the B string, first fret, just like the C chord, but now you're going to put your middle finger on the D string, second fret, and your ring finger on the G string, second fret as well. Same thing, don't pluck the low E string, just A string on down. For the F chord, I'm doing something like an F2. You can do a traditional bar chord shape, or even the one that you probably know, barring the bottom two strings, then G string, second fret, and then D string, third fret. You can get away with that, or you can play an F2, which I like to play. Put your ring finger and pinky on the third fret, covering the A and D strings. Then put your index finger again on the B string, and you get this sound. Notice I didn't strum the low E or high E, because otherwise you'd just get an F major 7. All right, for strumming pattern, well, again, there isn't an acoustic guitar part in the song, so you can make your own strumming pattern up, or you can make your own picking pattern. And this is a great song to do that because there really isn't a loud part in the song. It's very chill. So this is something that I would do during the song, starting in the intro. Now, if that was too quick for you to understand, that's okay. I'm going to play along with the song. I'll put the chords on screen for you. I'll say them as we go along. And then after we play through the song, I'll show you exactly what I was doing for that picking pattern. All right, let's get started, and here we go.
C. A minor. F. C. C again. A minor, F, C. Hold that C. A minor, F, C. C again. A minor, F, C. F. A minor, C, G, F, A minor, C, G, F, G, A minor, C, G, F. A minor. C. A minor, F, C. Hold that C again. A minor, F, C. A minor, F, C. F, G, A minor. D minor, C, A minor, G, F, G, A minor, D minor, C, A minor, G, F, G, A minor, D minor, C, A minor, G.
Well, everyone, I hope that I was able to help you out with that tutorial. So let's break down some picking patterns that I use throughout the song. And really, it's just as simple as you can make it. You could even do something like this. Let's start at the very first verse. So I'm going to play that really slowly and say the chord as we play. So here's C. Just let it ring out. Now A minor, F, C. Sorry about that buzz there. So let's break it down even further, just a little slower, and focus on the right hand now. I'm actually just putting my thumb on the A string. Looks like my index finger is on the G string and my middle finger is on the B string. Not worried about the highest string right now, just being very subtle and allowing the piano to shine. There's that C chord. I'm using the same strings when I pluck the A minor. And then F, same strings again, same strings when you resolve on C. Now that's very simplistic. You might have seen me do something like this, a little hammer-on action with the C chord. So it's the same chord progression, but now I'm just moving my middle finger off the D string and then putting it back on. Using that same picking pattern, A, G, and B, and then moving my thumb to the D string and then hammering on again with the middle finger on the D string. Middle finger, B string, and then thumb on the A string to end that right after the hammer-on. Now that's getting really, really picky, and I don't want to go any further because I think you guys could probably figure out something that would work better for you or something that really fits the song even better than what I showed you. This is just the basics, just the foundation. Maybe if you're just starting to learn guitar, this is probably something that you might want to try out. So thanks so much for watching, guys. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Hit that like button and comment below on what else you want to see in the future. Thanks so much for watching. Have a great week. God bless.